Hello and welcome in this today's video, third video of chapter units and dimensions. So today we will be talking about dimensional analysis. So in the previous two videos we talked about some of the basic terms which are required for this chapter, and in the second video we talked about the equation n1 u1 is equal to n2 u2. What is this all about? You can check out my previous video and see. Now we will talk about dimensional analysis, and in this we will talk today only in today's video we will be talking about the dimensional formula. Okay. How to write a dimensional formula of a physical quantity. So before that, let us quickly recap what are the physical fundamental quantities. These are length, mass, time, temperature, which is ampere, luminous intensity, which is candela, amount of substance, which is mole, and temperature, which is Kelvin. So these are the seven fundamental physical quantities, and based on these quantities, in terms of these quantities, we will write a derived quantity. What I mean to say, let us see. So if I have, let us say, volume. Volume is length into breadth into height. Yes. So now what we will do, this right hand side, this one, we will check that whether each of these quantities L, V and H are related to any one of these fundamental physical quantity or not. If yes, then we will write these in terms of these one. And if not, then we will try to further simplify this and then try to check it. Okay. So now this length, we can see that directly it is written the same words exactly. Okay. It may not be same word, but we have to think and understand that it is referring to the same thing or not. I will tell you in this video further. So length is written. So we will write it as L. Now we are saying breadth. Now suppose if I have, this is the length. Now if I have this breadth, okay, this is let me draw it here. This is length, yes, and if I, this is breadth, so this is covering some distance, some length, yes. Now breadth, we are also seeing that breadth is also some distance, some height, some length. So we can write breadth also as L. Okay. As I told, it may not be the same letter, but we need to think breadth is also a kind of length. Yes. Height, again, some height, some distance, and some length. So again L. So what will be there? L cube. Now, while representing, we can write it in this square bracket also, or we can leave it also. So this will be the dimensional formula for volume. Okay. And if we write it like this, volume is L cube. So this is called as a dimensional equation. Okay. Let us see. So now if I talk about velocity, okay, let us talk about the velocity. Velocity. Now in this chapter, or rather in this subtopic, we need to have the basic idea of all the basic formulas like velocity, work done. In the world of current, we need to know the every formula, force, acceleration, energy, all those things we need to know. Okay, and we need to know the terms. So, what is velocity? Velocity is nothing but displacement per unit time. Okay. Now, again, we need to. Okay, now we will check first. Displacement. Displacement is what is nothing but a kind of distance only, right? If is traveling some distance, okay. Right here, it's traveling some distance, right? So it is also a length, displacement, distance, all these are length, right? So we can write it as L in terms of its fundamental physical quantity, we will write. And time is simply a fundamental physical quantity. So we will write it again. It as T and we will write it in capital letters. Now L and T will come up to T minus 1. So this is the dimensional formula for velocity. Now let us check about acceleration. A. So again we need to recall what is the formula of A. That is rate of change of velocity, right? That is final velocity minus initial velocity per unit time. Okay. So this minus sign we will not look it now. This is also velocity. This is also velocity. So we will write simply velocity by time. Okay. Now what is okay? Now we will check that if velocity is related to any of these fundamental physical quantities or not. So when we are seeing, so we are not getting any kind of idea that if velocity is related to not. Basically it is not related now. So what we will do, we will further simplify. Now we will recall the formula of velocity. So what is velocity? That is displacement by time, yes. And this is upon t. Now again we will check. Now displacement, yes, it is length, I told you, and time both are fundamental physical quantity. So this time will come down, this is t square, yes. So distance we will write as L and t to the power minus 2. This is the dimensional formula of acceleration. Okay. So I hope you have got the idea of how to check and write the dimensional formula of any quantity. Now let us work on few examples. Let us see about force. What is force? Force is MA, mass into acceleration, yes. Now, in this chapter, at least I should recommend to learn 15 to 20 basic dimensional formulas of some basic physical quantities so that we can solve the questions quickly. Okay, right. I will tell you in this chapter further how it will help, because there are many equations which are very big and involves some kind of small formulas like this equal to force into work into this. So if we know the dimensional formula force, work, etc., so we can directly multiply or divide and get the dimensional formula. Otherwise we need to simplify and see, so it will take time. So it is a matter of future. So let us see. Force equal to mass into acceleration. M is simply a fundamental physical quantity, and acceleration just now we have got is Lt minus 2. So we will put Lt minus 2. This is probably the most important dimensional formula because it will be used in many of cases. Okay. So these basically all these are basic, but this is most important because it can be used in many other things. Like for example, let us see the next one. If we talk about work, so again I told we need to know the formula, right? So work is force into displacement. Okay, basic yes, force into displacement. Okay, F is cos theta is there, but trigonometrical ratios are dimensionless. I will tell you in this upcoming videos. Okay, so force. We found the dimensional formula of force, m l e minus 2, yes, into displacement is what? Basically length only, yes. So we should know that if if there are, if the bases are same, like a to the power n and powers are different, and if they are getting multiplied, so base remains the same and the powers get added. This is m plus n, it becomes like this. Here also we can see bases are same. This is l power 1, l power 1. So we will add up their powers. It will become l power 2 e to the power minus 2. This is the formula or dimensional formula. Okay, dimensional formula for work. Now if I tell you find the dimensional formula of energy, okay, now by the basic common sense we know that energy is spent is equal to work done, right? Jitna amount of work we will do utna hi energy will be lost, yes. So by this we can say that the dimensional formula of energy and work is same, okay, which is ml square p minus 2. This is the dimensional formula of energy as well as for work. Okay, now let us see a bit complicated, not complicated but lengthy calculation. Find the formula. If I tell that to find the dimensional formula for gravitational constant, gravitational constant, again I told we need to remember these formulas. It is constant, basically is a term from gravitation. So we know that force is gm1m2 by r square. Okay, this is both are mass and this is radius, yes. So we have to find a formula of g. So this will be f r square by m1m2, right? We know the formula, dimensional formula of force, mlt minus 2. If we don't know, we can also find f is equal to ma, right? Then by simplifying this we can find, but if we learn it is easier. Now this is radius. Okay, so if I draw a circle here and if this is a radius, so we can see it is also basically a length only, right? Some distance, some length. So radius we can also write as L. So R square, so L square, and this both are mass, so m square. Alright, now we will simplify it. So basic exponential, bases are same and they are getting divided, right? So this becomes a power m minus n. Okay, the powers are subtracted, bases are same, this is m power 1 upon m power 2. This is what become m power 1 minus 2, which is minus 1. This will get added l cube and p power minus 2. So this is the dimensional formula for gravitational constant. Now let us see some of the more like density. It is easy, but Let me use this. If beta of density is, so we write density as symbol. The symbol for density is this. It is called as rho. So density is what? Mass upon volume. Mass is simply n, volume is L cube. Yes, I told in previous, I think the first or the second formula. So this will become m L minus, right? This is the dimensional formula of density. Let us see some more questions. About the last formula, it is potential energy, right? So potential energy, we know that potential energy is m into g into h. Yes, so g is what? G is acceleration, right? It is acceleration due to gravity. So we can write a in place of g simply m a h, right? Now think, what is this ma? This is nothing but force, right? Force equal to ma. So in terms of, in place of ma, we write f into h. We know the dimensional formula of force, mlt minus 2 into height. Height is length only simply, so we will multiply length l square and t minus 2. This is the formula of potential energy. And let me tell you, all the energy, whether it is kinetic energy, whether it is potential energy, okay, mechanical energy, basically it is some of this. So all the type of energy, if it is an energy, so it will have the same dimensional formulas, okay? So that's it for today. Hope you liked my video, okay? Today due to some error, I am not able to capture my video. So, but it's okay, no problem. Learning should happen. So from next video, I will bring the uses of dimensions, okay, and we'll check how to see whether a formula is correct, dimensionally correct or not, and all those things. So for today, hope you liked my video and hope you got how to see whether the formula is correct and how to write a dimensional formula of a physical quantity in terms of its fundamental physical quantity. So yes, that's it for today. Thank you.